Can I flow through space? Can I escape this? Can I never look back? Can I erase this? I don't wanna live again till I do it right the first time. Learn from my mistakes, I'm just fine. Never wanna see me like this. I don't wanna see me like this. Can you tell me where I've been? I don't feel like I've been anywhere important. Too much past, I'm feeling fortunate. Look through the glass, the time has passed so torturous.
What's up guys, McKenzie here, and today let's talk about Destiny 2's game engine. Now real quickly, let's talk about what exactly a game engine is, you know? What the fuck does that mean? I guess let's put it in simple terms. A game engine is kind of the exact same thing as what an engine or an actual engine is in a car. The engine runs the car, right? So the game engine runs the game. Now that's in simple terms, but whatever. So Destiny 1's game engine, if you don't know, was very good, but also very bad. One of the biggest, you know, drawbacks in Destiny 1 was its very own game engine. But one of its greatest advantages was its game engine. The game engine allowed, from what I've read, huge optimization across all console platforms. I mean, if you don't know, Destiny 1, if you've never played it on last gen, looks amazing on last gen. There's a lot of limitations in Destiny 1. There's just so many issues that the developers have talked about that they have with the game. Like, for instance, they've talked about how if they ever want to, like, change something and end the game at all, they would have to like load up the servers. That would take like an hour, and then they would have to like go in there, tell it what they want to put in there, and then it would like take a whole hour to save it. Then it would take like a whole another hour to like turn off the servers or some crap. It sounds extremely complicated, but basically I'm sure you all know what the hell I'm talking about, and just how there's really good things that come from the Destiny 1's game engine, but there's also tons of really other bad things. So what will be Destiny 2's game engine? You know, obviously it's gonna have to be an upgrade. You know, they're gonna need a game engine that's gonna be able to allow them, you know, just get in there and just create content, right? Also give them complete control over everything, tons of other features, and just tons of other technical stuff that I won't explain. Now things are different this time. We won't have last gen to hold back Destiny 2's game engine, so they won't have to spend time creating all these optimizations for last gen when they could just do it all for the current console generation. But of course, we'll talk about that later. Right now, let's talk about context. You know, what I have theories on what will be Destiny 2's game engine, but I need to tell you about Destiny 1's game engine and where it originated from and how they created it and all this other crazy stuff. Well, I'm pretty sure you're all familiar with Halo 1, Halo 2, and Halo 3. Well, if you didn't know, Halo 1, Halo 2, and Halo 3, and also ODST and Halo Wars, but let's just talk about the main games. They all ran the same game engine called BLAM. BLAM is as old as 1997 when they created the game engine for Halo 1. You know, so they used the same engine across the board for Halo 1 and Halo 2 and Halo 3, all the way up to 2008. But in 2008, Bungie was like, okay, you know what? Fuck this shit. We need to make a new one because the BLAM engine's just outdated, at least across multiple platform optimizations. Well, really quick, if you want to know where I'm getting all my information from, there's a nice little PDF in the description where you can read about all the stuff that they talked about. One of the technical directors at Bungie, they did like a presentation about the game engine in Destiny 1 and where it came from and how it was created, and this is where I'm getting most of my information from. So basically, there was like, okay, let's create a new game engine. And this is where the Tiger engine came in. The Tiger engine is the game engine used in Destiny 1, and believe it or not, in Halo Reach. Some of you already knew that part about Halo Reach, and maybe even Destiny 1. But let's quickly talk about the creation of the Tiger engine. This is extremely important to what Destiny 2's game engine will be. So Bungie goes and says, okay, we have three ways of creating a brand new engine for their two new IPs coming out, Halo Reach and Destiny. And one of the three options was one where they could go buy one that was already, you know, working and created. They could number two create a completely another brand new engine, or number three, they could evolve their current engine, the BLAM engine. And apparently that's just exactly what they did. They evolved the BLAM engine into the Tiger engine. Now just exactly how they evolved it, what they quoted was they basically just, they kept all the good things from the BLAM engine, but none of the bad stuff. and created the Tiger engine, and, you know, added, you know, with technology and all the cutting edge stuff, you know, they just stockpiled it on top of there. It's a lot more technical than this, but, you know, I'm gonna simplify it for you guys. They just added a bunch of really cool shit to it, but got rid of all the bad stuff that came with the Blam engine, and kind of made it modern, if you will. So, really quickly to point out, the Tiger engine was used in Halo Reach. Halo Reach was released in 2010. That is when, I'm going to say officially, the Tiger engine was created, and necessarily that's how old it is. It's been alive since 2010. We're in 2017 at the current recording time, and so the Tiger engine is so far 7 years old, right? So then now let's start talking about Destiny 2's game engine. From what we know, Destiny 2 will have to obviously be extremely optimized for both consoles and PC. Not to mention Bungie, they're not ones who go out and buy another game engine, nor create another one, but it is possible that they created another one. But from what I was reading in the post, they were constantly talking about how... But when I was reading the presentation, they're constantly talking about how when they were evolving from the Blam engine to the Tiger engine, it was a huge risk, right? They were talking about all this other stuff and all the constraints that they had and everything, but something that they kept constantly repeating towards the end was it was worth it, and that you should take big leaps. And one of the main reasons why we have Destiny 1 and why it's so well optimized and how it looks so good and shoots so good and feels so good, mind you, fact that we ignore some of the other problems that it has, it's still an extremely well optimized game. So we could probably lean towards the fact that Bungie's might probably evolve the game engine again. Blam ran from 1997 to 2008. That's a pretty decent time span, right? Well, in modern times, technology moves much faster. So from 2010 to 2017, which, quickly, let's say Destiny 2 has probably been in development since Taken King came out. So about 2 years so far, Destiny 2 has been in development. A little maybe under or over that. So in modern times, the Tiger engine is extremely outdated. And they have probably 9 times out of 10 for the Destiny 2 engine, if I had to take a guess, they were going to evolve the Tiger engine into whatever the hell they want to call it. And keep this in mind, what they're probably going to do is keep all of the good stuff and none of the bad stuff with the Tiger engine. Of course, when it comes to being modern, they're just going to stockpile all of the new crazy stuff and optimizations on top of the brand new engine and call it their new engine. And that's probably what Destiny 2 is built off. Now, I could be wrong. They could have improved the Tiger engine to not be as shitty as Destiny 1's engine, because they could do what they did with the Blam engine. You know, from 1997 to 2008, they constantly had to improve it. You know, when you're building a new game, you don't just create a new engine every single time. You sometimes build off the last engine, outdated, so you had to update to a more modern technology. So they could have done that. They could have said, let's try and make sure we get rid of some things, but let's still stay with the same engine to reduce development time. So maybe building a brand new game engine, they didn't have enough time for that. We can take a good look at Destiny 1, and when we go to Destiny 2, when it's revealed and whatnot, it'll probably feel a lot like the original. That's probably Bungie's main concern. They want the game to feel a lot like the original, you know, all the good stuff, but none of the bad stuff. You know what I'm trying to say here? So, new engine, but none of the shitty stuff, same gameplay, but none of the shitty stuff, and that is what Destiny 2 will be in terms of the game engine and all the other aspects of it. But obviously, who knows, we're just gonna have to wait till May 18th when they reveal the gameplay, and we can probably get a good idea of what the game engine looks like. We won't necessarily know what the game engine is, but if we, you know, just look at the graphics and the way the everything else works, you can probably see that it's an evolved version of the Tiger engine. And, you know, why should you care that they're updating the game engine? Well, that this means that the game will be better. I'm just gonna say better. You know, I'm not gonna go into technical details. It'll just be better than Destiny 1. All the bullshit that Destiny 1 had in terms of its technical limitations will probably be eliminated in Destiny 2. I bet you when they were developing the game, this is something that they were extremely picky about. You know, they knew that they were going to have to constantly output content. They probably created a game engine that would allow them to just get in there, create shit, and then just give it to the community as fast as they can. Hopefully, that is exactly what happened. I wouldn't doubt it. That's what they did. Well, that's the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like it if you like it. Dislike it if you dislike it. Let me know what you think in the comment section below, obviously. And while you're at it, go to my channel, watch some of my videos, see if you want to subscribe. And if you don't want to subscribe, well, you're just a big asshole. Rolex with the diamonds, keep me shining. Gotta have perfect timing when I'm riding. Brand new Aston Martin, no mileage. Ooh, 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 yeah. And when you think about the fuck can I speak? Oh, I'm so clean and them people now they all talking. Show up to the spot and now everyone there watching. Don't wanna prove you wrong, but shit, you leave me with no option. Yeah, yeah. Now she hopping in the old school.